Hey and welcome everyone to another Warface weapons guide. And Warface has updated to the spring update, and it's very fitting because we have very nice spring weather at the moment outside. And yeah, there's was some changes to the game. Though before I bore you with that, please have a look at the Warface launcher and see what's new in the game. There's some interesting updates to the game. And yeah, we're gonna continue to the weapons section. Today we're gonna have a look at the sniper class, and last time we had a closer look into the SVK default sniper rifle in the game, and we're now going to the common section, and the next rifle there is the AC7, and the AC7 the same as the ZX84, a wall weapon type, a wall weapon range, and it will have a distinctive look. You can see that here. It looks a bit fishy in my humble opinion, but it's it has its specialties, you will see that, and we're gonna compare that indeed to the SVK, the old default weapon, and we can see we get 10 more damage. That's maybe necessary, not necessary, we can argue about that. I don't think in sniper rifles 10 more damage doesn't matter that much, but we take that with us because it's a positive effect. The range stays the same with 60, and I'm a little bit skeptical about that because ranges go usually up for sniper rifle to 70, so 60 is not the best, but it's a good operative range, so we're gonna have a look with that if that's any problem. The RPM, we get an increasement of 20 rounds per minute here. That's nothing to sneeze at, but also not the biggest bonus, but combined with other bonuses, we all get a better gun in total. The aim accuracy stays the same with 104, and that's almost the best you can have on a sniper rifle. And the hip accuracy decreases though actually by one, so we cannot shoot so good from the hip. Could still try by one minus points, it's not a big effect though. The clip size will increase though by 4 shots, and that's quite interesting, especially since we found out that the SVK is a 2 shot gun, not a 1 shot gun, and by the damage I would say just by the stats that the AC7 is also a 2 shot gun, and we're gonna have a look at that in the safe house. Here in the safe house, we're first gonna have a look at the attachments indeed, and we can see the rifle has to be used with a scope, and so it's attached with the default sniper scope, 5.5 times magnifying here. We can also choose, if we have unlocked it, the mid-range sniper scope with 4.5 times magnifying, and we do have the short range sniper scope with 4 times magnifying. And since this is a 2-shot rifle, this means we're gonna only have 60 range. This means we're gonna operate a very much more probably in the medium range than distance range, and surely not on close range. So I like to go with only 4 times magnifying, because that gives me the best orientation using it, especially if we have to do 2 shots on enemies. And rail wise, I'm gonna go with the sniper rifle bipod. I'm not gonna use that too often because I'm not proning all the time, which then only the effects would be applied in. But in case it happens, I would have the bonuses of decreased recoil and decreased sway. So muzzle wise, we do have the option between the shared silencer, which would eliminate the sound but take a lot of damage, so we avoid that. But there's something interesting if we have unlocked that. There's the sniper rifle suppressor, and we can decrease the muzzle flash. Not so important for PvE, but the damage drop is interesting here. The decreased damage drop, especially on range, and the improved penetration on armor is something we're looking into, especially on harder levels where PvE enemies are a little bit tougher to shoot down because their armor is increased. So yeah, let's see. We know that we need 2 shots to down an enemy. Headshots, just 1 shot indeed, like on every sniper rifle. So every sniper rifle can be just used for doing headshots. No problem with that. We're gonna have a swig load at the recoil. We can see though, if we don't aim, the gun shoots very weirdly around. Some shots might be actually go where you do, some shots go very far off, and you can see the distance that's of your enemy. That's not worth an attempt, you will just lose time killing an enemy, so don't try without aiming. If he's that close, switch to your piston, finish him off. So aiming, that's a different story. We see the weapon goes a little bit up, but swiftly goes down to the position where he was aiming at, and you have very good accuracy. Just going a bit up here, I'm sorry. A little bit dry throat again, and yeah, so on distance, even on the last distance, that shouldn't be less than 2 shots on enemies, as we can see. Very nice gun. Just the range, it might be that some enemies are a little bit far away, might have to use a 3rd shots on those, if we can reach them. Headshots, no problem with this rifle, and you can see it swiftly goes back to the point where you started aiming at after the recoil's done. And yeah, very nice gun. Let's test it out. And here we are in the helicopter. I have brought some competition with me, some engineer with a super weapon. And there's another sniper with the R16 SBR, so let's see what we can do against that. I think the stats are not so different. It has lesser bullets and a bit more range and a bit more damage, but not so much so we can compete against that, actually. Problem's gonna be the engineer, and we are starting off here, getting the first kills, hopefully. And I do have the first blood. Yeehaw, second kill here. Nice, nice, nice. Let's see how long the engineer will let that happen. And there we see two shots. If we don't hit the head immediately, two shots necessary. I'm gonna reload already. Not necessarily, actually, with still 8 bullets left. Two shot kill. The engineer has this trouble. Close range, this gun is horrific, but we can use it because it has quite some RPM. Here we're helping the engineer again. This guy is coming towards us. Oh, I should have pulled the gun. Now I'm doing some kills without aiming. As you can see, it's possible, but you need to have at least 3 shots to make at least one hit. But yeah, it's quicker aiming, actually. Ooh, I really like the speed aiming here. I'm not a very good sniper, so I don't know if I'm showing that off very good. We're trying to get that one. Leave that to the engineer. Nice shot here. Headshot by default, by randomness. Engineer's helping us. Close range. That's actually a good team here. If engineer and sniper, engineer running ahead, taking the close range enemies, and the sniper helps a little bit if he can with the ranged ones. I'm not hitting here. That's actually bad. Doing a perforating now. Okay, leaving some kills actually to my friend the engineer here, and I'm calling him as a friend because he's really helping me here. Come on, go down. Now we need to hide a little bit. I think we left an enemy in the rear. Yeah, but the rifleman takes care about that. Now we need to be a bit more careful. Engineer dead already. Ooh, grenade. Let's see. Okay, that's a dicey situation here. Actually, I should be the one in the rear and fighting them and not up front. Okay, last one probably attacked us already. Storming ahead. Now, it was a little bit dicey here. But I have to say, even if I never liked sniping so much or never played it as much, I have to say, if you look, I have about 200 hours of Rifleman game time, but basically 8 hours of Rifleman. So I'm really probably not the best guy to show you rifle guns, but I have to say, what I can show you, even if I'm a noob with sniper rifles, this rifle does make it fun. And as you see, enemies coming close, I'm running away, turning around and shooting them. Damn, that's a good tactic, I think, for me at least at the beginning. And yeah, I know I have to go 2 shot, actually, because I have my other team members around me who will try to get kills as well. And the rifles do have a little bit less problem orientation, because their zoom is not so hard magnifying here. Now I have to be a bit careful with all the melee fighters. And I should get out a little bit here, because that's a bit dangerous. Okay. Now the other have the problem with the... And we see that's his death already. I couldn't help so quickly because I took my time, sweet time reloading here. Quite actionized game as a sniper rifle. Usually I'm used to your hang. Oh, I'm out of ammo. That's bad. So I have to go with the pistol from here on. I'm very sorry. I hope that the engineer can finish them quickly, enemies quickly off till we get to the checkpoint. And now he has a lot of trouble, and if I can't help him, I will be in big trouble, because I will be the one left over. Two guys are actually lost already. Let's storm ahead. I need a checkpoint to gain some ammunition again, and I should be a little bit more careful, because, yeah, the next part's gonna be tough without ammunition. Yeah. Okay, here we got ammunition again. Reloading now. And let's see if we can actually get into action again. They're probably starting to storming ahead now to get the last two shotgunners. See if we can help there. Nope. Now at the bridge. I think that's the best position for a sniper to help there with the enemies. So you're getting taken damage if you shoot through glass, but it's possible to hit them. I'm just not aiming very well. And he gets the headshot before me because he has a golden gun. Ooh, nice there. Okay, this is our job now. Ranged enemies. There's the next one. Stealing kills from the SPR-16 here at the moment. He does the damage, I take the kill. Okay, they're storming already ahead into the generator room. Ah! Shooting, jumping though with sniper rifle is a bit of ludicrous. I'm not yet at the point where I can actually steer that. Okay. Where are my enemies? Where do I usually find them? Nice headshot here. Let's try to protect this side. We should be probably running out of ammo soon. Yes, we can see that. Okay, this is dicey at the moment. Okay, let's see. Okay, still have some ammunition left here. I'm not taking the risk going for headshots here. I'm taking the last ones out for two shots because they're too close and probably my enemies want them. My teammates want those enemies as well on their account. Nice checkpoint here again. We are full of ammunition. Ready for the last part. Should keep some ammunition for the outside part indeed for the snipers. Because that's going to be our task. Unless we're going to let the engineer with his golden gun run ahead with his incredible accuracy here. Awesome. Yes. That was also our task, but we missed to get the spec ops. I'm a little bit sleepy still, so bear with me. Still my first game today. I should have taken the time to do some practice. Did not do that. So, yeah, you're all right complaining about me right now. Okay, let's see. Ah, you've seen the recoil prevent me from getting actually my enemy. Well, that's okay. We could help the team, even if we didn't get the kill. Ah, indeed. He knows how to get all the kills. There we go. Just the distance ones we can have on our gains on, because that's our position in the team. And you see, I need at least 3 shots on those. Couldn't even show that, because by the time the engineer with his golden gun took the enemy out after I hit him the second time. Oh, that was a 2 shot. That was actually close enough again. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Not looking so good here as the sniper with the sniper part. But I hope you could see this gun is actually very nice. You can, as the most, 2 shotguns with 16 bullets in the clip. Use it for assault. You don't have to be a one in the white leaning all the time back. You can go in the middle, sometimes even assaulting with this rifle. I would call this an assault sniper rifle. It's nice to be ahead with it. Quick look at the scores. And yeah. Ooh-wee, that was some action game there. And yeah, let's have a look at the stats. The damage was increased, but I think that didn't really matter here in the last game so much. The range 60 is good enough for a 2-shot gun. I would prefer a little bit more range, indeed 70, if I have a 1-shot gun. The RPM is the really important spot here about the gun. Because for a 2-shot gun, you're looking not so much into having more damage. You're looking into having the 2 shots that's necessary to kill an enemy. Very quick to be behind each other, and the aim accuracy 104 is what we get on most sniper rifles, and it's very precise, and that's what we need on a sniper rifle. The hip accuracy, we lose one little point in compared to the default weapon, so that shows or says we still can do close ranged enemies without aiming, but as you can see, we probably need at least 3 shots to have that 1 shot where we need it to be. The clip size 16 is also very nice, because for a 2-shot gun you need much clips per magazine. And technically without headshots we can do 8 kills here. So I have a little question to you, since I'm not the best sniper rifle player yet. I have to practice that still a lot. I've recognized in-game I did have my trouble zooming in and then turning left-right. That took quite a while, and the others was always able to get my kills there. And I'm wondering, If you use the sniper and the rifleman, do you use different mouse sensitivity settings there? I wouldn't wonder if you use maybe higher sensitivity on the sniper rifleman. So yeah, let me know what you're using. Maybe not in numbers, but if it's higher or lesser sensitivity in the comments. And if you like the episode as much as I like recording it, because it was really fun, then leave a thumb up and subscribe. And until next time, good night and good fight.